While economic signs are improving here in Pittsburgh, the city is still operating under Act 47, financial distress.
Yeah, so why do you and I then help pay the thousands of dollars in trophies and cookies that was spent last year?
As the new Peduto era begins, Channel 4 Action News investigator Bopti Imam is asking about questionable taxpayer expenses.
We didn't find this story searching for money spent on cookies. We filed a public records request for details on city council member expenses over $500 last year and were told we couldn't get it. Instead, the city referred us to their website where we sifted through crumbs of information. Here's what we learned.
I have a responsibility to 310,000 people to make sure that we're living within our means and that we get out of this financial quagmire once and for all. We're not ready to do that.
Shortly after Mayor Peduto took office, he asked the governor to keep Pittsburgh under Act 47 state oversight for financially distressed municipalities, citing the need for more economic reforms. But has the city paid close attention to smaller approved items that added up to thousands of taxpayer dollars? When we looked into city expenses for last year, before Peduto took office, we found council approved nearly $15,000 in trophies, nearly $4,000 in medals, $3,200 in plaques, and nearly $1,000 on awards. In all, about $23,000. The Parks Department ate $700 worth of cookies. That doesn't include the $400 they spent in 1 month on pastries, muffins, bagels, and coffee service delivered. We found Public Works forked over $1,900 on refreshments for the Society of Municipal Arborists. Under the former mayor's expenses, council signed off on proclamation covers with gold foil imprints totaling more than $2,800. The city spent money on Customer Service Awareness Week, too, more than $500 for promotional items.
What probably surprises me sometimes when going through invoices is exactly what they're being spent for. And it really should come down to the purposes of government.
And Peduto's former chief of staff, now a councilman himself, argues that handing out plaques to citizens sometimes does fit the purpose of government.
You have to keep a quality of life. If we got down to the point that we did nothing but provide, you know, police services and pothole patching, would people really want to live in the city?
But Dan Gilman says some expenses are simply wasteful.
And we see that every week with what council votes on in the invoices. You'll see three different departments paying three different print shops three different prices for printing. Why do we not combine that and use one vendor?
And we learned something else in our investigation, too. Some city council invoices missing from the city's website. One invoice we later discovered showed more than $1,900 in proclamation folders. Councilman Corey O'Connor says there's no excuse for invoices that are missing and others that lack detail about where the money went.
We need to have a reason why it's going to that, whether it's a group or it's an event, something like that.
Peduto says the city has recently established a financial operations system that tracks and monitors spending, holding departments accountable.
It's something that we're supposed to be doing.
Ultimately, Gilman says council needs to play a more upfront role in the budget process, questioning department spending details before the money rolls out. Just last week, records show a $200 reimbursement for flowers for swearing in. And we spotted this Parks Department expense, about $100 spent for the tree lighting ceremony on 8 pizzas.
So when these things come before city council, that money is already spent. They don't come to us for approval.
The mayor and some council members say they hope to get some of the items sponsored in order to help cut some of the costs. As for Peduto's financial tracking system, he says it's not operational yet. He says they plan to add a performance-based element to that system, then make it public. Bopti Imam, Channel 4 Action News.